My name is Thomas Gossmann, but friends call me Gossy. That's fine if you do as well, and that's also my GitHub panel. So I started using module unification very early, around AmberConf or some time when it was first mentioned. And then what you do is like call Ember new on the command line, and then you have to pass a lot of environment variables in front to make it work. And when you do that quite often, it's becoming tedious. And also, I struggled with the other parameters you have to put there. For example, dash dash yarn, if you want to use yarn. And then sometimes you forget that if you're lazy to put it into the global config. Same for the dash dash no welcome. So if you forget that, that's the first thing you remove from your code. And if you finally manage to put dash dash yarn in, and then in your, if you decide to use a workspace, and then you know, you are in the workspace, and then you want to create a project there, then you probably forget the dash dash skip git. And so it was like, this is just Ember CLI and not FFmpeg. So it should be a lot easier, right? So I still like to create up a project called Ember CLI create. And the first thing I do was like, mimicking the Ember generate pattern. So for example, there's like Ember generate, blueprint, and then name. So I was like, okay, Ember CLI type name, where type could be like an app or an add-on, and then the name of the project. So this is what I released, and probably some of you have seen. But when I was like using it, I felt like, oh, we could do probably a bit better here. And just create to Ember CLI create project. And probably when we explore, I'm gonna show you what that holds. So this is something I'm working on, I can show you in a second. And probably we can someday have this as Ember create, maybe. So let's see how this looks like from the command line. So this is just, yeah. Not the command line. There we go. Can you see it? Is it big enough? I can make a little bit. Okay, so this is just because it's in development. It's just this code, and it should be like Ember create or something. And when you hit this, it prompts you with a command line wizard. And what it does is it presents you with some presets. So just kind of what project, what Ember project you want to create. And I don't know if you remember your first time using Ember CLI, and you were like, what do I need to type? Is it new? Is it Ember? What? And if you run this, and the first thing is, yeah, if you're a beginner, use this. Like, go that way anyway. If you already familiar with Ember, you can use one of the other presets. So like Ember is going like to following this path of Ember up your way, and Ember CLI create can help with that. So it lets you create an Ember app, an add-on, or the Octane stuff that Tom is mentioning in the morning. Also like going low level, just creating a Glimmer project or a Glimmer web component. Or you can also go just a manual way, and then it asks you what you want to create, an app, an add-on, or maybe someday an engine. So we stick with the app. Then we give it a name, something like very, very descriptive here. It asks you for the location where you want to create it. And then it asks you some features. For sure you want to create, use all of that. And the others, I just put them together because I think that might be useful. Probably has some handy, so didn't do any research on that. And you can also select some experiments you want to use, for example, of course, this one. And then if I click enter, it will fail because that's something I'm working on. And but I hope on my train ride home I can fix all that stuff and probably create a release when I'm home. Yeah, that's it.